Netcasts you love.
From people you trust.
This is Twit.
Bandwidth for iOS Today is provided by CacheFly at CacheFly.com.
Coming up, Mailbox is dead, but dry your tears. We have so many apps that are so much better.
Plus a battery pack with a protrusion problem.
And go home, Octo Dad. You're drunk.
It's time for iOS Today. iOS Today is brought to you by the Ring Video Doorbell. With Ring, you can see and talk to anyone at your door from anyone in the world using your smartphone. It's like caller ID for your home. Right now, get free expedited FedEx shipping in time for the holidays when you go to ring.com/iOS today. And by Wealthfront. Wealthfront is a low-cost automated investment service that is the most sophisticated way for you to invest your money. Whether you've got millions or you're just starting out, visit wealthfront.com/iOS today to sign up and get your free personalized investment portfolio. That's wealthfront.com/iOS today. And by Texture, the mobile app that lets you access the world's most popular magazines anytime, anywhere, using your phone or tablet. For your free 30-day trial, visit texture.com/iOS. Woohoo! The iOS Today Show is on the air, starring Megan Maroney
and Leo Laporte.
Hey! This is the show where we talk about all iOS devices, not just iPads. We've expanded to include iPhones, Apple Watches, and Apple TVs.
Apple TV, yes, all the things. Today, last week we told you Mailbox, the Dropbox email client, was dead.
Yeah.
So sad.
So sad.
We got lots of emails. What do I do now? What do you have any suggestions? My suggestion is always Outlook for iOS, but a lot of people had some
which
issues.
Is pretty good.
Yeah, I really like it.
And before you poo-poo it, it's not like your desktop Outlook, Microsoft Outlook.
No.
They bought a Complete, which was a very credible mail program. Mm-hmm. And it's essentially, at least for now, until Microsoft starts to mess with it, a Complete.
Right.
And that was one of the first, like Mailbox, to have sliding back and forth. So a lot of the, if you liked Mailbox, a lot of the features in Mailbox were in a Complete.
Right. Well, that's the big one, being able to swipe to reschedule. That's the thing that was so
love
great.
Love that feature.
I don't want to look at it now. I want to look at it in an hour. I want to look at it tomorrow. I want to look at it
Here's
next week.
Here's the good news. Mailbox didn't patent it.
No.
They didn't copyright it.
Well, bad news for them. Good news for us.
Yeah. So many, in fact, almost every mail app now, including Google's own Inbox, which is what I use, duplicate that.
They duplicate it.
Do you use Inbox at all?
I do. I use Outlook and Inbox. So let's take a look first at Outlook. And so you should know that Outlook isn't just for Gmail. I mean, it is. You can use it for Gmail. That's what I use it for, but you can use it for other things too. That's the problem with Inbox for Google, for Gmail. Right. You can only use it for Gmail.
Right.
So let's take a look.
You can still download Mailbox, right, for the time being.
You can't. I have it, yeah. I don't know. I had it before,
so
they didn't take
working.
It away. But yeah, I think they're maybe going to stop developing it.
I bought it. I don't have it on my iPad, but notice I can download it. So if you ever bought it, you could still, you probably can't buy it anymore, but you could still have it.
Yeah. So this is what Outlook looks like on the iPad. And if I want to, here's John sent me this email. I could archive it by swiping right. And I can swipe, by swiping left.
So this is what we were talking about. This is a nice feature.
Yeah, and then I can schedule it. And by the way, you can change these if you like to swipe the different.
Yeah, I'm a lefty, for instance. So
I'm going to schedule it, and then I'm going to think about this email that John sent with a hole in Leo's iPad Pro, either in a few hours this evening, tomorrow morning, or I can choose a time. And I don't want to think about that broken iPad Pro until never.
So, never.
Monday, February 10th, and then it disappears.
That's close enough to never.
Exactly. The other great thing about Outlook is it has a focused versus the other inbox. So this is focused, all the things that Outlook thinks I'm going to care about versus other, which are just like, well, here's this, you know, advertisement. Here are my Twitter notifications, my newsletter. They put all that so I can focus on what's important and then not on the other.
What would we consider to be kind of must-have features of an email program? Why is it people liked Mailbox so much?
The swiping to archive.
Yeah.
I think that's a must-have. Some people's must-have is printing, which Outlook doesn't have.
Oh, that's interesting.
And that is not my must-have. And I had a conversation on Twitter with somebody about that. And they just said, sometimes you need to print an email. And
yeah.
So I don't. But I don't know of one that really supports printing. Another must-have feature. Well, there are a lot of must-have. Another must-have that doesn't work for Outlook is full-screen email. So I can't see... This is the only, I can only do the two panels. I can't see this whole email full screen, which, I mean, that would be huge on the iPad Pro. But I get it if you're on your iPhone and you want to see something full. So Outlook is free. You can use it with any email account. You can use it with multiple email accounts. You can edit your Word documents, your Excel files right in the email, which is nice if you use a lot of those. So I like it.
Let me show you what many consider the power tool of Mac email programs. I've heard from many, many people who like Boxer. Have you ever heard about Boxer?
I have heard of Boxer, yes.
Yeah, and I've mentioned this before, so it's not, you know, my first time mentioning it. It's got many of the same features, and that's what's interesting. They've all kind of converged. For instance, mm-hmm. you still have this, well, let me get my head out of the way, swipe to archive, and then that swipe right, and then to do. But notice... besides to do, if I swipe a little more, I get to do. But if I swipe that far, I get actions, and then there are a bunch of quick actions here, some of which are configurable. Okay, so and I can say it's spam. I can send it to Evernote. SaneBox is a cloud service that's I love this filters out and summarizes unimportant emails. So this is kind of like Unroll Me. We've talked about that before, mm-hmm. where it will unsubscribe to newsletters and junk mail you don't want. It will add automatic follow-up reminders. It will allow you to snooze emails. So we can enable SaneBox, and I'm using it on my Gmail account. And so what this does is creates a folder called Sane Later that it moves stuff to. These are heavy-duty features that, and this is part of one of the reasons, I'm not going to do it right now, but this is one of the reasons I asked, what do you consider important? Mm-hmm. For instance, Boxer includes a calendar and contact list. It's kind of like Outlook for the desktop, where it has all of the additional features. I like the quick responses. This is something Gmail's added to the inbox now. These are customizable. Mm-hmm. Gmail's inbox, which you're going to show in a minute, is funny because it makes them up based on what it reads in the email.
Right.
That may make people happy, may make people a little nervous. I don't know. But these quick replies are editable. And they're actually very similar to the Gmail quick replies. So let me show a couple more actions here. Label, which is nice. Archive, delete. And you can add it immediately to your to-do list, which I like. And this is interesting. You know, traditionally you have a star mm-hmm. for, but I can like email, okay? So that sends a reply to the message to say, I approve. And everybody who said, so this is if you're on a team.
Right.
And you know how it often happens that you get emails from people like, I don't know. We sent out an email because This Week in Tech was on iTunes.
Best of podcast.
Best top of 2015, right?
Yeah. So congratulations, by the way.
Well, but wouldn't it have been easier if you just say like?
Yes.
And instead a like button.
You know what would be easier if I said, here's what I want to do next week on iOS Today.
And I responded.
With a like. Oh, instead of what you
I
usually
could do,
which is radio silence.
Blow you off. So, well, wait a minute. Let me find your email. You see, the problem is I get a lot of email. This also has really good filtering capabilities. Boxer, if you're looking... Oh, let's not show that. If you're looking for... No, it's just a license number. You're all welcome to use that software. No big deal. If you're looking for a power tool... this is the closest thing, and I kind of like this, the closest thing to a desktop application on iOS. So the people who really, and for some people, email's everything. This is a good choice.
What makes that more of a desktop application than Outlook?
The fact that it has contacts and calendars, the fact that it has all these actions that it can tie into Evernote, Facebook, and Twitter. In other words, it's got filtering built into it. Mm-hmm. It has the features of a desktop computer application, which typically programs on iPads are kind of like subsets. They're simpler. Mailbox was much simpler, right?
Outlook also connects to your calendar, which I really like. And, you know, it allows you, if you have a date in your email, you can just tap it to add to calendar.
Yeah, I like that feature. Now, I don't mean just connects. It has your calendar in the app.
So does Outlook.
It does now?
Yes.
Outlook. That's nice. Well, they've added that. Okay.
So Outlook.
Microsoft bought Sunrise, which is a great iOS calendar. Okay, so very similar. Mm-hmm. Do you have your contacts in there, too?
Yeah, people right there. Don't show that, though.
Shoot, you got the same thing.
Yeah, I got all my contacts.
Okay. So these are very similar.
And my files.
Nice thing about Outlook, it's free. Boxer is not free.
Yeah. Maybe you hate Microsoft and you don't want to use a Microsoft product.
Could be.
Boxer is,
could be.
So inbox for Google. If you are a fan of Gmail and you have a Gmail, I recommend inbox for Google if you stay on top of your email.
Well, it's designed to have you.
It's designed to help you, but if you're never gonna.
That's why I stopped using it.
Yeah, it's gonna be very confusing.
It's too full of stuff now.
Yeah,
it's really designed to be doing inbox zero on a regular
basis. Yeah, it's designed for people who are like, I'm gonna spend 15 minutes and I'm gonna get control of my inbox because otherwise I'm gonna be insane and the clutter's gonna drive me crazy. Mm-hmm. I'm speaking from personal experience or anything like that.
I have inbox, as somebody in the chat room said, I have inbox 27,364. I'm excited about that.
I am working on inbox zero, and I do feel better. I will say, emotionally and psychologically, I feel better when my inbox is cleaned out. I feel better being able to respond to people on a timely basis and put things in their place. Okay, so here's what it looks like. And it does have, you were talking about the smart responses. So here's an email I got from Jason Howell who said that he wants me to find all the moments across all Twitch shows and clip them out of their own source video files and edit them together.
Like that button.
So I can say, I'm glad I could help, my pleasure, or I'm glad you like it, which is none of the response that I was going to use. I was really going to say, what are you talking about, Jason? I'm not going to do your work for you.
Yeah.
So it's not as smart as it needs to be. But if I wanted to say I'm glad I could help, then I could just say I'm glad I could help and then send it there.
You kids, don't fight. Don't fight.
So here's a picture that Patrick Delahanty sent me of bunnies. I always want to keep that in my inbox. I'm never going to do anything with it, so all I have to do is pin it there and then it's there because I like to see bunnies. And then there's the swiping to archive, swiping to schedule, same thing. So I would recommend if you have 5 minutes a day just to spend on your email, this is the way to go.
Press that red plus button there, because that's the compose button.
Yes, I'm going to compose.
But notice they've added a new feature, which I really like, reminder. So this is new from Google. And it ties into the fact that email is often a to-do list in some ways, right? It's it's tasks.
Yes.
Jason set you a task.
Yes.
So you can now hit reminder and add a reminder, the little blue hand. And by the way, this is, notice, going to start tying into more than just, and look at these. These are some of the things you can do. And it ties into your Keep, your Google Keep, if you use that. It will notify you. It will remind. It's like iOS reminders reminders, but it's googly. It's Googlified.
Yeah. So I want to remind myself to watch iOS today on.
See, look
YouTube.
At that, and then look at that.
There it is.
Isn't that cool?
That is cool. I can watch.
Yeah,
it
that's
right
a
now.
New that's a new feature that Google just added to both the iOS and Android, and I like that. I actually was using Wunderlist. We've talked about that.
Oh, yeah, we have,
And I've abandoned it because I now have basic to-do list functionality built in Inbox, and that seems to be the way it should be.
I love Inbox, but it will confuse you if you really like to keep a bunch of emails in your Inbox.
Which I do.
All the time. I have one more. Do you have another one?
I have another one, so you do one more. I'm setting up this one because I haven't used it in a while.
Spark? Here's what it looks like on the iPad right now.
Okay.
Not so good, right? They do, no.
That's not good.
No. I have heard a rumor, I read an iDownload blog, that they are coming out with an iPad app soon, but for now you can use it on your iPhone, which I have here. How can you see that? So this is what it looks like. It organizes according to emails from people in my contacts list, then newsletters, or you know, someone's trying to talk to you on Twitter, and then it does everything else. So I guess it emails that I need to respond to are on the top, and then newsletters all go down below. So I can swipe to pin or swipe to archive. I can just click the archive. I can schedule to later. I can do all kinds of things. Spark I really like. They have a really good Apple Watch app, which is nice. When I first used it, it was draining all the battery out of my Apple Watch, but they have since updated it, and it is much better. So Spark is free, not for the iPad yet, but coming. And yeah, that's Spark email.
Okay,
I actually have one more after
stall.
That. You want me to do my last one?
Yeah, would you? Because I
zero.
Have to.
This is one I've talked about before, and this one is the one that has the full screen email. Spark did too, but zero is really for someone who your main goal is to have inbox zero. So everything comes in, and you just swipe up or swipe down like you're on Tinder or something to get rid of your email, and then everything goes in your inbox, and you can look at emails unread, just like so. So this is if anybody looking for full screen, zero is good. So then I just go, yeah, I don't want that, I don't need that, I don't need that, I don't need that. I'm just swiping, and then if you do want to keep something, then you say keep an inbox. Like that, like so. And then when you've reached inbox zero, you get this pleasant little picture of flowers and a nice little pat on the back.
So we mentioned that to do that email, and this is why I asked you at the front, what do you use email for? Because everybody has kind of a different use for it. For me, email is kind of a database of every interaction I've had with people. A lot of times there's email and phone numbers and mailing addresses and other information. And so what I want to do, and this is one of the reasons people use Gmail, is I want to keep every email I ever got. And I want to be able to quickly search it so that I can find all of that stuff. The iPad's not great for that. In fact, probably if that's what you want to do, if you want to search your Gmail, for instance, you should launch Safari on your iPad and use their search. But if it's to-do lists, it's action-oriented, this is a program that is both a desktop app and available on the Macintosh and an iPad app. It's called Mail Pilot. And I'm actually in the demo real quickly just to show you the features. You can swipe messages just like everything else, right? And complete it. But it treats every message as a to-do list. So notice, remind in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 days. Okay?
Ooh, that's nice.
Yeah. For more actions, tap and hold, and then you can flick it towards one end of the edges of the screen to complete it or to select a list, and then I can put it on an existing list, right? So this is, we'll go out of this. We'll go into the actual mailbox. Let me find a, here we go. This is a nice email. I'm going to allow it to access my contacts. Now, it looks, as most do, like pretty much like a regular email program. In fact, it's kind of simpler. Some people love Mail Pilot. Some people say, this is terrible. But you can try it on the desktop for free and see if you like it. So complete, set aside, remind, add to list, delete, move to a folder. What it really is getting things done. It's the getting things.
GTD.
It's GTD. It's the getting things done kind of methodology. I wish, frankly, slide to close without sending. Whoops. And this is another problem I have a lot on the iPad, which is when I slide from the top, I often get my notifications pane and not what I want. You can add attachments. And that's another thing, by the way. Boxer and others will allow you to add attachments from Dropbox and other sources. This one, yeah, it's kind of a little bit. You got Google Drive and Transporter. It's a little more limited. Maybe if I had Dropbox installed, I could do that. I think this is really primarily focused. We're going to cancel this out. Let's take this down. I think this is primarily focused on the to-do. There we go. The to-do list person. It's called Mail Pilot, but the idea is to kind of keep your to-do lists, you know, and the tasks that you're assigned via email in order. So if that's what email is to you, this might be a very good choice. And it does have a desktop component that syncs with it. So it's nice for that reason as well. Yeah. Mail Pilot.
Oh, that's interesting.
I wanted to try Spark, so I'm glad. Yeah. So what did you think of Spark?
I like Spark. I've used it, and I liked it on the Apple Watch. Yeah, I like it, but not. I think I'm already, what do you call it, lock-in?
Yeah.
Buy-in to Inbox, Google Inbox and Outlook.
Well, now that Inbox has that reminder feature, I'm using it a lot more because I want my reminders. I also think Google's really kind of got it down in terms of the display. I love the, you know, like messages with
the way
with things show.
Yeah, videos show up in
like
there.
There's a picture of the BlackBerry Priv that I ordered and stuff like that.
And so then you can remember, because remember you couldn't remember if you ordered it or not?
Yeah.
Now you know.
Right. And I guess I didn't, so I get it Wednesday.
Yeah. Well,
be doing a review for
PC Guy 8088 in the chat room says he thought email was dead. I don't think email is dead, but you know what might be dead?
I wish it were dead.
You know what might be dead?
Is that anything to do
with home when someone rings your doorbell.
Does that have anything to do with doorbells? Because
We're
never home when someone rings our doorbell, but wouldn't it be nice if you could act as if you were home, especially if it's that someone is Santa, mm-hmm. with a special delivery.
Right, and you never know if you can trust Santa.
Or a bad guy mm-hmm. who wants to remove items from your home, mm-hmm. not add them. Or grandma who thought she was supposed to arrive on Wednesday and it's Tuesday. Or, you know, that kind of thing.
Right.
So the Ring video doorbell is such a boon. It's kind of like, I think it's kind of like... like a neighbor looking after your house, but without the nosiness.
Mm-hmm.
What it is, and it's actually really easy to install. If you have a wired doorbell, you just two screws, remove your old doorbell, two wires sticking out of the door jamb. This is what I had, and it was very easy to add the Ring video doorbell. It just replaces your old ding-dong doorbell. Still rings your chimes, but does much more than ring your chimes. But what's nice is it also has a battery, and it doesn't have to be wired. So you can put it in places that don't have doorbells. Like apartments, for instance. Now, it connects to your Wi-Fi, has a beautiful big HD wide-angle camera on the front, as well as speaker and microphone. So, when somebody rings a doorbell, ding-dong in the house, but also ding-dong all the other places you are on the internet. So, my Ring video doorbell actually rings my iPad, rings my iPhone, and I can answer the door from my iPad or my iPhone. I can say, hello, please leave the package there. I'm in the shower. Or I could say, hello, you look like a scary person. Run away. And the truth is, home burglaries about 95% of the time happen during the day while you're at work. The bad guy rings your doorbell to see if you're home. If you don't answer, he's going to go round back and break that window and get in. But you will answer, because no matter where you are, see, there he is. You could tell he's the bad guy. And that guy's doing something to scare him off so he can go back to his hot date. That's the Ring video doorbell in action right there. You know, this would be a great gift for your family, especially your parents, your elderly parents, if you have them, or family members who aren't as sophisticated. It just makes you feel better about it. I love my Ring video doorbell. We couldn't live without it. And this time of year, you also kind of want to keep an eye on those packages on the front porch. So I want you to go to ring.com/iOS today. Check it out. You can also get free expedited shipping, which means you can get it to your family and friends or yourself in time for the holidays. Free expedited FedEx right now when you go to ring.com/iOS today. That's a $20 value, that expedited FedEx. We love it. Have you installed one?
I haven't. Not yet.
I think it is so cool. I could log on to my Ring account on here, and I will. And then what's fun is while we're doing the show, I can see people coming and going from
that
house.
That is smart.
Nice. Yep.
So here's your reminder. Get your updates. There was an update for the iPad, the iPhone, the Apple Watch. It is not easy to update the Apple Watch. It takes a long time. You have to be charged and 50% battery. But I did it. So get your updates. You talked about the battery case with the protrusion problem.
You want to see it? I got one.
You probably heard of this. This was just...
It's always a big deal when Apple announces a new product.
Right.
So there's a lot of press, even though this is not an important product.
There's press, and then there's press about the press, and
right.
then more press about how there wasn't
press. Put yourself in the position of an Apple blog or MacBreak Weekly, where we got to do a show every week, and Apple blog's got to do hundreds of articles every week. There's not a lot of news, mm-hmm. so it's something like a new battery case from Apple that's going to get a lot of attention. This is so I'll tell you what they all said, and then I'll show you what it is. This is only for the iPhone 6 or 6S. So one thing the pundit said is, well, tacit admission from Apple that the iPhone 6 just doesn't have enough battery life. I don't know if that's what that means. They didn't make it for the 6 Plus, but there's good reason. You don't need one,
right.
Do you? I mean, really.
I think it's those apps I was telling you about last week that, like, track how much you're on your phone and track when you're texting and walking.
Are you running?
And especially when I go to San Francisco.
Oh, I never run
I don't run out of juice. I get too low.
Like, what's your carrier?
Sprint.
Okay, that's probably more of the issue.
Oh.
Because you say it happens when you go to San Francisco. This is often the case. If you go to areas where your phone is roaming a lot or mm-hmm. seeking a lot, that means its radio is on a lot. It can make a huge difference in battery life. So if you have good battery life here in Petaluma, but then you go somewhere and the battery life suddenly is terrible, that's what's going
that's
on.
What's
it's
going
the radio.
On. Okay.
Not much you can do about
right.
that, except leave Sprint.
Well, sometimes I just run my phone on low power mode when I'm in San Francisco.
Right.
Because you don't
There's
need
one
it. It's
solution.
Not like you don't need
yeah,
it.
Yeah, that'll help. Right.
But or... If you have a 6...
Well, a lot of people have Mophie cases. They've been around for a long time.
Anchor was another one.
Anchor's $30 for a pretty hefty case. And so the other thing pundits said, and this one I agree with, is Apple, why don't you tell us what the specs are? They never say how much battery is in here. They say, it's roughly going to recharge your phone. Roughly. I want to know how many milliamp hours are in here, okay? Now, maybe that's not a meaningful statistic because people, I don't know. But everybody else tells you. That's apples and apples. It is, I have to say, it's that nice silicone rubber. It feels like Apple patented this rubber because it's so soft.
Is it the fluoroelastomer?
It's probably the fluoroelastomer.
Same thing.
It's soft. You know, it's the same material used in the plugs on the Mac Pro.
Oh, interesting.
And the tires on B-52 bombers, of all things. So this bends back, and that's what's, you know, it's easy to put on because it's so soft. But the other thing people said is, where was Johnny Ive when they designed this hump? Now, I'll tell you what I think. I think Johnny said, you don't need, because every other case, they hide the hump by making the whole case bigger.
Right.
Johnny's saying, we don't need to do that. We need form to follow function. And there's a battery, and you don't want to hide it. That's what this is, a battery. So there's no extra material. It's just exactly, it's true to the actual case. It's the battery plus rubber to make the case. Why hide that?
It's transparency. Johnny Ive is all about transparency.
He's all about truth in advertising.
Tricking you with his beautiful voice.
Now, the other advantage this has is because it's an Apple product, of course, it's got the lightning port, and the phone knows about it, so you will see the charge state in the phone in the notifications as you do with the Apple Pencil. That's something no other battery case does. But then there's a strange thing that I think Sir Johnny must have missed.
Mm.
There is a light to tell you the charge state, but where is that light? It's inside the case.
Oh.
So when you have a phone in there, you will not know. We don't want people to see unnecessary lights when you're using the case.
So you don't know what?
How you can't tell what the charge, that's what the light tells you.
Whether your case is charged.
Yeah.
But you're supposed to charge it with the case.
You can do it from the pull down, right. So I guess that's the idea. The other thing somebody complained about, maybe it was Serenity Caldwell, is while the lightning port is physical on the bottom, so that you plug into the bottom and it duplicates itself as it plugs into the phone, not so for the earphone plug. It's just a hole in the case.
Yeah.
And while Apple's earphones pass through just fine, many earphones, including the Beats headphones.
Beats, yeah. Christina Warren was saying
that. That's right. The Beats headphones, she had to get an adapter, an extender.
Yeah,
so that's something to be aware of. But, you know, that's true of many cases. It's got a nice soft lining, like the inside of a deer's tummy.
Mm-hmm.
That's about it, right there. That's
$99.
It's expensive. That's
$99.
The other thing. How much is the anchor?
I don't know. You said it was $30.
$30.
Yeah.
And more capacity.
Yeah, so. But can my problem with some charging cases, you have to charge them separately with a micro USB cable, and then that just adds more complications.
Yeah, this is nice because it uses lightning. Yep.
I have a charging station for my whole family. And it just
also
gets confusing.
It does the right thing because I think the right thing, although, you know, Mophie cases give you a switch to decide what the right thing is. But in this case, Apple, we don't want switches. We want to have a pure experience. What it does is it keeps the phone at 100%. So the first thing to draw down is the battery in the case. So that way, when you use up the battery in the case, you could take it off and you still have 100% on your phone.
Mm-hmm.
For most people, I think that is the right thing. That's what you want. But the Mophie case lets you switch that off and on if you don't want it to be that way. So there it is. I mean, it's fine, but you have many choices, some less expensive, none of which have the Apple logo on the back.
So some intrepid friends from a place called Bullet Train are here today in the studio. They
I'm going to put my Bullet case
on. The Bullet case, which has some really cool features.
So yours is on, but
mine is on.
I can show you what it looks like with
it off. Yeah, take a look at what it looks like.
This is kind of neat. So it is a safe wallet. So it looks like it's just a hard shell case.
Mm-hmm.
A little thicker because inside you got some, you got your cards, you got your money, you got your
keys.
Your keys. There you go.
And you've got a pen. You've got a pen.
That's kind of cool, too.
And it's a real pen. And the reason they put this in is because when you're at a restaurant, you have to sign your name, and you're touching a pen that someone else, like a million other people have touched, you're going to get their germs.
That's
but
not
now
the
you have
reason.
Your own.
Is that really the reason you guys gave? You're so OCD. The real reason is you never have a pen when you need one.
Well,
that's the reason.
Restaurants, they usually give you a pen.
But not just restaurants. There's times you need a pen and you don't have one.
Yes.
That's the reason. Anyway.
He likes to promote your product at the same time he insults you.
It's a little OCD to say, well, I don't want to touch the pen at the restaurant. Please let me open my safe. I've brought my own. Thank you very much. Now, if you bring your own fork, that I'd understand.
Yeah, that's true.
But a pen? Okay. The other thing, this holds two keys. One on the top, one on the bottom. It's a little sticky. So when you put the keys in and then you open it up, each key is visible separately. He showed me that. This is from a company called Bullet Train. This was a Kickstarter. Was this a Kickstarter? Yeah. They raised three times. They went to the well and came back loaded with money. And so this is it.
Now they have a product to actually sell.
Safe wallet.
And you can, the other cool thing is you put all your credit cards in there and then you slide through so you can see.
Oh, that's
neat. It allows
you
to see what they are so you don't have to take the whole thing
out. And how much is this?
$79.99.
Don't forget the 99. That's your profit. It is for the 6 plus. $79.99, the safe wallet from bullettrain.com.
Oh, yeah.
It could stand up on its own?
Yeah.
Wow.
So, yeah.
So it's a stand. That's neat.
Yeah, here.
It does everything.
Look at that. You can see my stand, too.
Bullet Train.
So thank you for coming all the way to watch the show and show us these cases.
I picked red. They have colors, you know.
A few other stocking stuffers. Have you tried these HRT, another Kickstarter that exists? They're digital sound processors.
High-resolution technologies, DSPs. Oh, so this is interesting because the Apple iPhone DSP is not what I would call... Is this for the iPhone?
It's for the iPhone or the iPad.
Okay.
And you can...
It's not what I call a high-res... It can't do high-res music.
Right, but that
but
is
this
what
can.
Makes it... Yeah, so you plug that into the iPhone or the iPad or into your
desktop.
So
it could use a lightning cable. Or a micro USB, so it would work with anything that can handle USB. And then that goes to your headphones. And inside here, it takes digit bits in and analog audio out, and it does it at a high res, it says.
Yes. So those are $70.
Oh, it's a headphone amp as well. Wow. Mm-hmm. A DAC and a headphone amp.
From HRT.
Nice.
And another one, a lightning to camera connector.
This I want.
Canon ear. Ooh.
Oh. Now, is this from Apple?
This is Apple's connector, yes.
So. They upgraded their camera connection kit, you know, to work not only work with the iPad, but if you have the iPad Pro, to work at USB 3 speeds. So I now have to run out and buy a new camera connection kit because I want that high speed. But that's what the iPad Pro
fast.
For me is going to be about photo editing.
Right. You connect your camera to, you know, its connector, and then you connect this, the lightning cable, to your iPad. And it was very fast when we were... I had to turn this on, I think.
Here, I'll do it.
Yeah.
I know how to do it. I'm a trained professional. Oh, it is on.
It is on?
Yeah.
There we go. So all my all of John's pictures are here. I can steal them
He's
off.
Our staff photographer.
And then I can just import them all.
Look at that.
And now I've got everything.
And it's pretty quick? Because those are big images.
Yeah.
Does it do raw, John? Probably not. Or maybe it'll import them, and then you just have to have a program that'll read them.
Yeah. Let's see.
John shoots JPEGs? Yeah.
So, yeah, that's 5 pictures already.
That's lightning quick.
That is lightning quick.
Yes,
that's true.
Yes,
so, you can stick that in someone's stocking or your own
stocking.
Yeah,
or the camera connection kit, which would read an SD card. And that camera uses compact flash, so you have to do it this way.
Mm-hmm. So Mashable came out with a list of the 100 iPhone apps of all time.
Man, do they work hard.
It was a really interesting list. And
did you agree with everything on it?
I didn't agree with everything on it. One thing I specifically didn't agree with, Netflix was on the list. And I guess that's a thing to watch Netflix on your iPhone. It's not iOS, just iPhone. But I don't watch a lot of Netflix on my phone. But I guess that's a thing to do. So I talked to Christina Warren, and we have a little video of how they came up with... the 100 apps, and I thought we could show that.
The idea came up this spring, and we started kind of working on it in earnest in July, and basically everyone on our tech team worked on it, and we circulated a list around where we nominated apps as, you know, the number one, being worthy of being on the iPhone apps of all time list. And then we rated each app on a bunch of different categories. So we rated things based on design, utility, cultural significance, App Store rankings. So we used App Annie data to kind of show how far how high it ranked in the App Store and how long it was there. And we averaged those scores and then, you know, kind of made a longevity was one of the categories too, and we averaged the scores, gave it a final score, and then ranked them. And then there were some cases where there were ties. You know, that actually the top three apps, our number one app was Instagram, our number two app was Google Maps, our number three app was Facebook. They actually all had the same score, but we then kind of got into lots of arguments and debates, and kind of all made our case for how we should end up ranking those three apps. And so a lot went into it. You know, there was a certain amount of subjectivity, you know, from the base of the editors, but there was also, you know, we tried to rank, you know, on a 1 to 5 scale in each of those categories and give things a numerical score. It was a really long process, but I think it really came together really beautifully, and it was a very, very large project.
So all of these apps are not still available, right? Some of them?
Not all of them are still available. There are a few, for instance, that, you know, were like Tweety was one of the apps that's there because it introduced pull to refresh. And it was so good that Twitter ended up acquiring it, making the official Twitter app. So that's not there anymore. There are certain other apps that you know, disappeared because either, you know, time in the App Store came up or you know, things moved on. Like one of the early iPhone games, Tap Tap Revenge, which was a really big hit. It actually originally debuted on jailbroken iPhones and then officially came to the App Store when the App Store launched in July of 2008. That hasn't been in the App Store for a couple of years. So when we looked at this list, we were really trying to go back to, from 2008 forward, what are the most influential and important iPhone apps? Not necessarily always even saying the best, but just in some cases the most important, or the ones that have changed the app ecosystem the most.
Well, Christina's great, and I like the list. As you were talking about, Yo was one that had a cultural significance, but maybe not a
long-term
significance. Meerkat, same thing. Meerkat was the first live streaming app, but now I'm afraid it's not going to really stick around. And a Periscope is there, and, you know, Facebook you can live stream, and it's, check out the list. It's interesting.
Flappy Bird, yeah. Do you feel obligated when you read something like this to download each and every one of those apps?
Absolutely.
Probably you have a lot.
Well, some of them don't exist anymore, so you can't.
Yeah.
But
VSCO, the VSCOcam, we love that.
QuizUp, I'm a big fan.
Ocarina, I would say 3/4 of these have been app caps.
Yeah, I think that, and one of the
Time
other things
Hop,
I've
you
talked
and I love.
About, Mailbox.
Mailbox, eBay.
Right.
Duolingo, we've mentioned, that's been an app cap.
Yeah.
MyFitnessPal, that's how I have looked so thin and handsome all these years. Draw Something, huge, gone.
Right, as it was Mailbox.
One
that Mailbox ended right after they came out with a list.
Yeah.
One thing we
talked
about.
It's a fun list, but you know, there's a lot of companies going to be doing this. This is a traditional year-ender.
Right.
Yeah.
But one of the things that's interesting is that I think the big companies like Microsoft, you know, but seeing how everyone loves Acompli, then they're going to buy it. You know, same thing with Dropbox and Mailbox.
Right.
It's these kinds of lists that I think.
So getting
companies
on this list could be the kiss of death, is what you're saying.
Well, it could either be the kiss of death or.
What's number one? Let's go to the. What is the number one?
Number one is Instagram. So.
See, I don't think anyone learned anything here because you all either use it or don't, but there's no mystery about it.
I thought it was interesting to know that.
I agree with
to
it.
Think about, like, wow, yeah, Instagram is really something.
You know,
that
on our, we should do this
changed.
On our end of year show. We should each pick our favorite app.
We
of the
should
year.
Do that.
Yeah.
Mm hmm. Let's
One
do
of these
that.
Days we will.
All right, but now let's talk about Wealthfront. What do you think?
You caught me mid-slurp, and I'm excited about Wealthfront, so I'm glad to talk about it, our sponsor today. Wealthfront is a company, a great company, that is solving a big problem for anybody who plans to be around for the next few years, right? If you don't need Wealthfront. But if you think you might want to save for retirement, save up to buy a house, maybe you've got kids and you want to put them through college, you need to save, you need to invest, because saving alone won't do it. If you've put money in a savings account in the last few years, you know that it doesn't exactly grow. I got 47 cents this year in my savings account. I'm so excited. I would have gotten a lot more from Wealthfront. Unfortunately, federal regulations mean I can't be a Wealthfront customer while I'm doing Wealthfront ads. It drives me crazy, but you can be a customer. Go check it out, wealthfront.com. Here's the idea. You got to put stuff away. You got to put money away. And you really only have two choices if you're saving for the long term. Either you manage it or you pay somebody to manage it. The problem is, if you manage it, A, do you have the skills? And B, do you have the time? And you need to manage it. You can't just let it sit there for years and years. You have to at least rebalance every quarter. And I think you need to think about dividend reinvestment and a lot of other stuff. So maybe you want to pay somebody to do this. But that is not cheap. typical investment advisor going to cost you between 1% and 3% of what you've got under management every year. Not to mention the hidden fees for transactions and other changes and charges. It's terrible. Terrible. You have to make 3% more to make up for it. Not with Wealthfront. Wealthfront uses computers. Computers work cheap. So they charge 0.25%. Computers do something else. They're fast and they're tireless. Wealthfront manages your money constantly, 24/7. Now, we're not talking day trading. These are long-term investments, long-term holds. But there is a lot can be done to rebalance, to do things like tax loss harvesting. And I guarantee, just ask your 3% investment advisor, are you doing tax loss harvesting? Nine times out of 10, they'll say, what is that? Direct indexing, optimizing your investment for your time frame, for your risk aversion. Wealthfront does it better than anybody, and there are no commissions, and it all costs 0.25% a year. It's nothing. No wonder Wealthfront has grown 20 times in the last 2 years, over $2.6 billion in client assets. And if you're curious, you can go there right now and find out what they would do, how they would set up your portfolio for free. Go to wealthfront.com/iOS today, wealthfront.com/iOS today. And for free, they'll give you the portfolio after you answer the questions about, you know, time frame. And you, by the way, you can have this be for everything. You can have this be a joint account, retirement account, individual account for a variety of different purposes. That's up to you, but Wealthfront will manage it all. And you can start with as little as $500. Here's the best part. They'll manage your first $15,000 entirely free of charge when you go to wealthfront.com/iOS today. That is a pretty good deal. No, not a quarter of 1%. No quarter of no percent. If that means anything. Wealthfront.com/iOS today. I think that's bad math, but it's okay. You get what I'm saying. Wealthfront.com/iOS today. We can't do it, but you can, and I would. Moving along.
We have some feedback. Bob in Hamilton, Ontario said, I was interested in your review of Paprika. That was the recipe app you recommended last week. He said, the one negative in my view is that it isn't universal. I'd want to use it on the iPad, then use the shopping list on my iPhone. To do that, you have to purchase the iPhone app. I wish they'd charge a bit more and make it universal. Oh, I thought you said you used it on the iPad.
Well, it's not universal in the sense that you buy it once on the iPhone and then you can use it on the iPad. It does work on the iPhone, the iPad, Macintosh desktop, Windows desktop, Android devices, Android tablets. It works everywhere. But yes, you have to buy whatever versions. Hugely expensive. It's $5. I mean, I think what they do, it makes sense. They are charging more. But only charging you for what you use.
But can you sync them across? Like
yes.
Your lists are, like
yes.
You make your lists on your iPad
yes.
And they show up on your iPhone.
Yeah. In fact, go to the settings and look at the sync button. You'll have to set up a free account with Paprika. And once it syncs, all your recipes, you can enter them anywhere. I enter them on the desktop because it's fast. With that cut and paste I showed you, it's really fast. This is called Paprika. But I cook with my iPad, the recipe's there, and I shop with my iPhone. And the ingredients are there. And it's everywhere that you use it. So, yes, as long as you do have to buy it. I mean, it's not hugely expensive. But because I have synced my recipes, the same recipes are on my iPad as are on my iPhone. So that's the key to me is the syncing. Meal planning is very easy. You can do menu planning very quickly. And it automatically generates a shopping list, which to me, and this, see, the shopping list is the same on desktop, on iPad, and on iPhone. And he's right. That's how I shop. I shop with the iPhone, and you can check them off as you go. And watch. I mean, as I check. So I'll check off the first item here, and then I'll sync, and that first item will disappear. And, in fact, it already did. It went gray on my iPad. Proof positive it actually works.
All right. Well, we have another comment from Michael. He says, in 2008, after being diagnosed with high cholesterol and a fatty liver, I did a lot of online research about healthy living and eating. I came across the book, Eat to Live, on your website, Leo, as well as the brief interview you had with Dr. Furman in 2009. This inspired me to get the book and change my life. Today, I am 25 kilograms lighter.
Wow, that's like 200 pounds.
Well, that's a lot.
Okay, maybe not 200
I don't
pounds.
Know. 25 kilograms
it's
sounds
55
like a lot.
55 pounds.
It's still a lot.
Still a lot.
And I've never been healthier. How amazed I was when watching iOS Today, episode 274, to see that now, being officially diagnosed with type 2 diabetes, you are revisiting your diet Dr. Furman's nutrition.
I am. I'm following. I'm following Dr. Furman's diet. I wish I had done it when I interviewed. I've been a fan of his for 7 years, but I foolishly ate like a madman, and now. But I've lost almost 20 pounds, and I plan to lose a lot more. And by the way, I'm proud to say my numbers have improved quite a bit.
Excellent.
And I hope we'll continue to improve.
Well, Michael's story is on happyherbivore.com. We can link to that,
Michael,
in the show notes.
I'm so proud of you. That's awesome.
He was the Herbie of the week.
Herbie of the week.
If you want to email us, you can do so, iostoday@twit.tv.
Say goodbye to your fatty liver.
Yes, you can make sure to tag your posts on Twitter with say goodbye to your fatty liver, and I will definitely see them.
No.
I'm Megan Maroney on Twitter. You can tweet me there. Let's talk about texture.
Texture is great. Lisa has a subscription. So I gotta share her subscription, but I love texture. Texture allows you to, instead of buying, when we fly, when we travel, both of us like to go to the newsstand, buy 7 or 8 magazines, because, you need trashy stuff to read on the airplane. Sometimes I get, heavy duty stuff because I want to read Wired and Popular Electronics and Scientific American, things like that. I don't have to do that anymore. It's all on my iPad, all ahead of time. It's called Texture. You may have heard us talk about Next Issue. This is Next Issue. Texture comes from Next Issue. And the idea is you can subscribe to all the best magazines and download them on your iPad and read them offline. You don't have to waste time finding premium content either, because they have an editorial team that recommends stories based on your interests. They have curated collections, so you can go into articles from magazines like Fortune and Fast Company and Newsweek and Rolling Stone and Wired and more. You know what? I don't like buying magazines because they just clutter up the house and I feel guilty about the trees. And most of the time, I only want to read one article in Allure. I'm not, I want to read the ads in Glamour. I want to get the latest recipe from Bon Appetit. It's not like I need the whole magazine. This saves you money, saves trees, saves clutter, and gives you access to everything. I mean, look at the list of magazines. Clean Eating, that's me. That's the new magazine. Dwell is great. We talked about that before. I love seeing beautiful homes and thinking, I wish I lived there now. Entertainment Weekly, well, you got to keep up on your celebrity gossip. This is nice because I can read celebrity gossip without actually, people think I'm reading Fast Company. Mm-hmm. They don't know. They just see it on the iPad. You get everything you would get with the magazine. And bonus stuff like videos. You know, we had for years, a grandparent gave us National Geographic every year as a standard Christmas present. This would be so much better. Not only less expensive, but kind of more stuff. It is a wonderful thing. Your loved one will gain unrestricted access to the world's best magazines, back issues to the one on newsstands today, automatically downloaded to their iPad or iPhone. I just love it. I just love it. What a great gift. A gift they'll open, all the time, every day, mm-hmm. for the rest of the year. Texture.com/iOS. You can try it free for 30 days right now. Texture.com/iOS. Get that mobile app. What's that? And start build. Did you just growl at us, Tony? Anthony said, iOS. Texture.com. Oh, it was that bird in the backpacker. Okay. Yeah. Texture.com/iOS to sign up and get your 30-day free trial. I love Texture. It's great in the gym, too. You know, put the
works
iPad.
It's great on the iPhone.
It works on Android. Works everywhere. Standing in line. When I'm standing in line, and that's when I buy the magazines, right? I say, I have to know what's going on with Gwen and Blake. I buy the magazine, and then I feel dirty. So
if you hide it, then you no longer feel bad about it.
Right.
Okay. This is the time where we wear funny hats. App caps. We wear funny hats.
Only
we talk about our favorite app of the week.
Can prevent app caps.
I like this hat because it matches my smart keyboard.
I bought that for Big Night Out.
You did?
Yeah, that's the charity event at mm-hmm. the Marco's school. Her husband mm-hmm. Teaches at...
Mm-hmm. Where your children went.
And my kids went, and I was a trustee, and they have every year a fundraising event, and it's a costume ball. So I had a mafioso.
Oh, nice.
A beautiful gray sharkskin suit, and I thought I was buying a scary Godfather-style hat. I didn't realize I was buying it in bright red.
Yeah. It does, good thing I can make
So I wore this instead, and they thought I was a Mountie in a sharkskin suit.
That's good. So my favorite app of the week was on the Apple TV, but it's also on the iPad, and it worked great on the Apple TV in my house. We're having some technical issues with our Apple TV remote.
It's broke. As the kids would say.
Yeah, I don't know. We've tried to change the settings, but anyway.
Let me try
thankfully,
it.
Okay, you try it.
What happens? You press it, nothing happens?
Go to down to Octodad.
Octodad, is that the game we want to try? Okay. And then we want to play new game
Anthony
or co-op?
It's the game, but I played this game just fine at home.
No, yeah, it's not responsive. So I guess we're stuck playing whatever, because I can't scroll anymore. Yeah,
I can play it on the iPad.
Okay, let's show it on the iPad.
Did you play Octodad? This is the sequel, Octodad.
Wait a minute, wasn't that a reality TV show, Octodad?
No.
He had 8 children?
That was Octomom.
Oh, Octomom.
This is Octodad. And it really does show how difficult it is to be.
Slide this a little bit.
It's hard to be a dad, you know. Sometimes you feel like an octopus.
Is he an octopus?
So I need to get that key right there. That's what I need to do.
This is interesting.
And I have octopus hands. So I could pick up that. I could pick up that by, I could suction that. Move 2 fingers to raise or lower your arms. Thank you.
Okay. The kids love this,
yes.
Do they?
It just kind of feels like you're drunk. I mean, they don't think that, but I do.
I do, too. I feel drunk watching you try to open that cabinet.
Does it feel like being a dad? So with the move 2 fingers.
Only after 20 vodkas.
No. Go. Touch.
I can't open this cabinet.
Tap to go into leg mode or arm mode.
Cabinet.
But now I don't.
I have a key.
I should be able to.
I should go right in there.
Fingers to raise or lower your
arm. I feel like somebody's moving my arm for me.
So you can see how difficult this would be with a broken Apple TV remote.
Hello. What the hell is
me.
This? Do you really want a game that makes you feel completely inept and incompetent?
It was really fun.
Wait a minute. I had to put the
key. Now what do I do?
Put the key in the keyhole. Oh, hang on.
I gotta get the other one.
This is where I keep my liquor.
You have to get exact.
I need some more.
So Octodad is getting married
here.
Okay, and he has to pretend to be
he's
a
getting
regular.
Getting married?
Yes.
Is that what you said?
Yes, he's. Pretending.
Oh, he's an octo unwed dad.
Yeah. Well, they're not. They first they get married.
Oh, they
the
actually
kids.
Go through the whole family
they
thing.
They do. Yeah.
Wow.
Oh, I see.
It must be hard when your tentacles are.
So,
get married. Do you actually end up making babies in this?
You have
8
babies.
Of them?
Now open the
That's
door.
How successful.
I'm hyperventilating just playing this.
It's kind of, it probably gives you the giggles, doesn't it?
It does.
It's hard
really
not
fun
to like.
On the big screen. Okay.
Especially on the TV, because everybody's watching. Oh, you broke the house, Octodad.
So, 2-finger swipe tap to move to leg mode. 2-finger swipe tap.
Okay, now you're in leg mode.
Now I'm in leg mode.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, God, this is funny.
Yeah.
This is funny. Forward. Oh, my God, Octodad. Oh, this would be a good Apple TV game.
It is really good.
Yeah.
I wish that our remote worked, because.
You know, the subtitle, I think this is a takeoff on Octomom, because the subtitle is Dadliest Catch.
Maybe, yes.
So there's a little reality show thing.
So I gotta get my tie. Now, how do I get back into leg mode?
Tap. Oh,
there we
no,
go.
You, yeah.
Get my tie. Grab my tie.
You grab it with your leg.
I got my tie.
You have done that.
I love this game. It's $4.99, I should tell you. It's not free. Some say that.
It should be.
Now I gotta open the door and move.
The kids
forward.
Love this, though.
Yes. I love it, too.
Really?
And you can use a game controller too. So,
is it easier?
I haven't given my kids my game controller yet. That for Christmas,
I have to
so
get
hopefully
this.
They're not listening.
You know what I love is you've been giving us some great Apple TV kind of co-op games that it'd be fun to have.
Yeah, that everybody.
Fun for
yeah,
the whole
there's
family.
Just a lot. It was fun for the whole family.
I could see Michael just howling and just like giggling.
You don't have to make a reference
off.
That he looks drunk. That's you don't necessarily.
I
you
no,
do
I
that
would.
If you wanted to. But.
He's not. He's an octopus.
Do you want to keep watching me play this game?
I have so many apps that I could pick right now for my app cap. I really.
You
but I'm going to show you one. Well, I was going to show you my light meter, but then I realized nobody has a film camera.
Some people do.
I'll mention Pocket Light Meter, which is actually a great iOS app that Chris Marquardt recommended for my new film camera that I've been shooting. And it's actually, if you're if you do need a light meter, you don't need to buy one. These camera phones are actually really accurate.
Yeah.
So this is not a reflected light meter. This is, you look through the viewfinder. Here, I'll show you what it looks like. You look through the viewfinder. You tap what you want to measure. You can change the ISO. It's got a wide range. I'm going to be shooting Tri-X, so that's ISO 400, and I'll lock that down. You can decide whether you want to lock down the shutter speed or the aperture. Here's another nice feature. Once you pick it, you can make a log note with the image of what, and obviously it'd be the image from the camera phone, but at least you'd know what you were going to take an image of, and you can just make some notes. And it will save out the settings as well. So that's a handy way to log your film photos. But then I thought, that's a pretty limited market. Mm-hmm. The light meter for a film camera.
Good point. Well, I don't know.
Well, I got another one for you.
Okay, good.
And this one came from Gary Koffler. It's also for photography. It's called Picasso. Not Picasso.
Not Picasso.
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 And it's one of a whole category of apps that take existing pictures and artify them. Like this one. This is you. In Picasso style, Cubist style.
I should do the whole show looking like that.
I think it's kind of fun. Well, you could also do it in Van Gogh. Mm-hmm. Starry, starry, Megan.
I like that.
Take your picture. So, I'll show you how it works. Well, and by the way, they also have a salon where you can share your Picasso images. And some people are good at, you know. But, let's paint, all right? So, you start by picking a picture. I have a lot of pictures on here. Let's see. Here's some selfies. Here's a selfie of me. It really doesn't matter what I use because it takes a while. And this is what's interesting about this. Then you pick the style. And these are the built-in styles. But you can also customize a style from existing photos. But I'll pick this style. Here's the thing. I can't show you the results right away because it sends it out to the server. The painting is submitted. And then we wait. I'm 45th in line. We wait.
In line?
Yeah, we wait. It
Someone's
takes about 10
them.
Minutes.
Someone's actually painting it.
I don't know. Maybe there's a human. I don't know. It sends it out to a server and does this, and you get it back. So it's kind of like film photography.
Oh.
You have to wait. But I like the results. I've seen other programs that do something similar, but I like the results from this one. Picasso with a Z. It's a couple of bucks. One more program. I'm going to give you a bonanza.
It's not App Caps.
This is an App Caps. Notability. Do you know about Notability? The reason I mention this is those of us who use iPad Pros are looking for good note-taking apps.
Oh, yeah.
And this is one Renee Ritchie mentioned on Mac Break Weekly. It is for, like, school notes. It's for writing down notes, but you can do it with a pen or with the keyboard. But one of the nice things that I really like is it will say you're at a lecture in school and you're mm-hmm. listening to lecture. It'll record the lecture as you take notes, and when you tap that part of the note, as you're taking notes, it will play back that part of the lecture later. So this would be a great item for a student. Notability, and of course you can draw, you can add pictures. It's a really cool program. And while of course it will work with any device, it's particularly well suited to the. Particularly well suited to the iPad Pro if you have a pen, especially. Mm-hmm. But you don't have to. So it's kind of like three. Three app caps in one.
Impressive.
Notability, Picasso, and Pocket Light Meter. Something for everybody.
Something for everyone. All right, well, that does it for this show. We didn't break anything. We didn't...
Well, it's not over yet.
And we got your little elf on the shelf.
Is this our last show before Christmas? No, there's one more show before Christmas.
One more show before Christmas.
But this is our last show. This is last night of Hanukkah. Mm-hmm. Happy Hanukkah if you're celebrating. And we'll be back... Christmas Eve? Is that right?
No, Christmas Eve is later in the week.
Okay.
So we'll be back here Monday, and
next
then the Monday after that,
we're going to do a special.
Yes.
Which we'll pre-record because we don't want to have to work on the week after Christmas. Plus, I'll be on a boat. Mm-hmm. We're going to show you how to set up all your new Christmas gifts.
Yep.
That'll be fun.
Mm-hmm.
So
we
thank
know what
you.
You're getting.
We know
we
it's
have the end. Santa Claus for this. But thank you, as always, for watching. Thank you for sticking around. Thank you for coming to the studio, our studio guests. I appreciate that, too. If you want to come be in the audience, send an email to tickets@twit.tv. You can email me, Megan@twit.tv. And everything that we talk about is in the show notes. So go there at twit.tv/iOS today. And make sure you subscribe to the show. That's the best way to get it fast.
Every week you want to make sure you get every one of them. Mm-hmm. Thanks for being here.
Watch live.
We'll see you next time.
Bye-bye.
iOS today. Smile.